Hello, and welcome to part 6 of the third of the 3 weekly lessons about Oracle Jet. In this part, you learn how to optimize performance in your Jet applications. Jet applications are client-side HTML5 applications. Most performance optimization recommendations that relate to client-side HTML5 applications also apply to Oracle Jet. In addition, some Jet components have performance recommendations that are specific to that component. In general, you can optimize an Oracle Jet application the same way that you would optimize performance for any client-side HTML5 application. There are many online resources that provide tips for performance optimization. For example, the Google Developers website describes processes for, among other things, optimizing caching, optimizing round-trip times between the client and the server, minimizing the payload size, in other words, the download responses from cached pages, minimizing the request overhead, improving browser page layout, and optimizing performance on mobile devices, among a range of other tips and tricks. Most of these recommendations are up to you to implement, but Jet itself includes features that can reduce the payload size and the number of trips to retrieve the Jet application CSS. The Jet Developer Guide contains a list of performance optimizations applicable to Jet applications. You should definitely take a look at this long list of tips and tricks. For example, in the JavaScript section, you'll see that Jet provides minified versions of the Jet library, as well as the third-party libraries when available. You also learn which aspects of performance optimization Jet has control over and which aspects it doesn't. In the CSS section, you will read about how you should only send the CSS that your application actually needs, and also, again, about minification and obfuscation of CSS. Performance optimization insights that relate to Jet components directly include the fact that you should only use the Jet components that you actually need. Build your page in HTML and add only the Jet components that you need. If your application only needs the component briefly, add it and then remove it as soon as your application no longer needs it. Also, follow the Jet component best practices. Consult the API documentation for each Jet component that you're using, and check if there are not specific performance optimization tricks and tips available within the JavaScript reference for your Jet components. Something else is that you should limit the number of Jet components to 50 per page. And for optimal performance, limit the number of Jet components on your page to set numbers for the type of component that you are using. For example, 5 components per page are recommended for OJ tab and OJ toolbar, 2 components per page for OJ chart, and so on. So take a very careful look at the performance optimization section and the related references in the Jet documentation. In this part, you've been given a range of tips and insights useful for optimizing performance in your Jet applications. For your homework for this part, use one of the existing applications that you have been working on during this course and try to trim it down to be as small as possible. You should be able to get to something quite a bit smaller, but just deleting unused SCSS files, component libraries, and CSS themes. And as a bonus task, if you are familiar with CSS, you can try trimming the default outer UI CSS theme to only include what your application actually uses as well. And with that, we thank you again for taking part in the Oracle Jet course and see you in the next part.